important thing is your intestinal glands or crypts of Lieberkind. The crypts of Lieberkind are also present. All duodenum, jejunum and ileum, all the three parts consist of this villi formation. Once the villi, after forming the villi formation, the epithelium is dipping into the lamina propria as a crypts of Lieberkind. This crypts of Lieberkind are otherwise called as intestinal glands. Like gastric glands, these intestinal glands are also lined by so many cells, and each cells are secreting different types of hormones and secretions. So what are they? We are going to see about the intestinal glands. So see, this is one of the crypt of Lieberkind, which is present in the small intestine, which is lined by epithelial cells. So at the surface, this is the simple columnar epithelium. Then next, from the surface in the upper portion of the area, these cells are simple columnar epithelial cells, which shows microvilli formation in the surface for increase the surface area for the absorption. So next, these cells are also secreting mucus, and in between the any two mucus cell, in between the mucus secreting, in between the epithelial cells, we will see one typical characteristic, goblet cells or flask shaped cells. These goblet cells are otherwise called as mucus secreting cells. So along with the simple columnar epithelial cells, we are also seeing the goblet cells, one of the characteristic feature of small intestine, because in the stomach we won't see any goblet cells, only mucus secreting cells. In the small intestine, you will see the another set of cells which secreting the mucus is a goblet cell, which is a flask shaped cell. So in the lower portion it is like this, and in the upper portion it is going to dilated, and it is consist of mucus secretion. But during staining procedure, this mucus will be disappear. So this empty looking cells are otherwise called as goblet cells. Along with the epithelial cells, you will see the goblet cells. The function of the epithelial cell is absorption, and the goblet cells secrete the mucus to protect the mucosa. Then next, in the middle portion, these are all the mucus secreting cells, and these are all the goblet cells. And along with this mucus and goblet mucus secreting cells and the goblet cells, in the small intestine we have a important cells called stem cells or totipotent cells or undifferentiated cells. So the stem cells are important features which are present in the small intestine. These stem cells are undergo differentiation into three forms. Some cells are going to form absorptive epithelial cell, and some cells are going to form goblet cells, and some cells are going downwards and going to differentiate some other cells. So these stem cells are important cells which are totipotent cells. They are going to differentiate it, they goes upwards and they replace the destroyed epithelial cells, and once again they form the new epithelium, because the gastrointestinal tract is the important portion which is going to form wear and tear because of absorption of food. So daily we have to eat, yeah? So to the destroyed epithelium should be replaced every 3 to 7 days. For this purpose, these stem cells are going to form some undifferentiated cell. From the undifferentiated cell, some cells are matured and they going to destroy, they leave the, or they destroy all these destroyed epithelial cells are disappear, and the mature or new cells are settled. Likewise, every 3rd day to 1 week this is happening. Then next to that, from the stem cell, once again some cells are differentiated to form the goblet cells, and some cells are going to form the mucus cells, and some cells are going to downwards and form other important cells. So in the base area of the small intestine, this intestinal glands, here one important cell otherwise called as Paneth cells, which contains of zymogen granules. So this pyramidal shaped cell, which is otherwise called as Paneth cells, These Paneth cells, which are pyramidal shaped cells with a basally situated nucleus, and in the apical portion it consists of so many granules, which are otherwise called as argentafin granules or zymogen granules, which are responsible for secretion of one enzyme, lysozyme. This lysozyme is very, very important for immunological reaction, because this is the intestine. We all know that we are exposed to foreign bodies or foreign materials through the food or water. So this Paneth cells are responsible for that immunological reaction, along with the Peyer's patches or lymphatic nodules. They secrete the zymogen granules, which release the lysozyme, and also it contains of zinc, and the zinc is essential for our immunity. That's why if you see, even during this COVID situation, they are prescribing zinc tablet, because the viral route is either it may be a fecal oral or it may be a respiratory. So to protect our mucosa or protect our gut immunity, we have to take zinc. So for any diarrhea or dysentery or any absorption related disorder, they will prescribe the zinc. What is the more? Because this Paneth cell consists of zinc, that is responsible for this immunity. So this is the Paneth cell is an important MCQ. Where it present? It present in the crypts of Lieberkin. What is crypts of Lieberkin? It is the intestinal glands. Where it is present? At the base of the intestinal glands. Then next, along with this Paneth cells, there are some other cells called enteroendocrine cells. Already we seen about these cells in the stomach also, which are secreting gastrin and somatostatin and histamine. Here they are secreting cholecystokinin and substance P and vasoactive intestinal polypeptide. These are all the some of the other hormones which are secreted by this enteroendocrine cells, which are present in the base of the intestinal glands. So these are all the important cells we have to know in the intestinal glands. So in the intestinal glands, the basic epithelium, which is the absorbed epithelium, that is the simple columnar epithelium, which so microvilli formation or gives brush border appearance, that is responsible for improvement of absorption. Other than absorption, to protect the mucosa, goblet cells and the mucus secreting cells for protection of the mucosa. Then next to that, stem cells for creation of new cells, for developing the new cells to replace the destroyed epithelium. Next, the important cells are enteroendocrine cells for the secretion of hormones, and then the Paneth cells, which contain zymogen granules, which secrete the lysozyme enzyme for immunity. So these are all the important features you have to know about the intestinal glands. Everything, these stem cells, enteroendocrine cells and the Paneth cells and the stem cells, goblet cells, which are present in the intestinal glands, this is an important MCQ point of view for your NEET and also for your 2-mark or 5-mark questions. This is about your small intestine. These are all the presenting feature. So next we are going to see about the large intestine.